So let's talk about the feasibility of the vision of active networks. Reality is, router makers like Cisco are loath to opening up the network. So while the idea of active networks is very fascinating, that we can be frugal about the resources that we use on the internet for different network flows, and we can actually virtualize the physical infrastructure by slapping on our own idea of what should be the kind of network flow that I want for my packets, seems very attractive, but really it's not going to be feasible given that we have to open up the network. So it's going to be feasible only at the edge of the network. Secondly, when we are using active networks, we are talking about executing code in a router in order to determine the routing decision at that node. Or in other words, we are doing software routing. Software routing cannot match the hardware routing because at the core of the network, there's so much of traffic being handled that you really want to do this in hardware. And doing this at software speeds is not going to match the hardware speed of packet processing in the core of the network. So once again, this argues that active networks is only feasible at the edge of the network. And finally, there are social and psychological reasons why active networks is maybe a little bit hard to digest. It is hard for the user community to accept arbitrary code executing in a public routing fabric. If my traffic is flowing through the network, and if the router is going to actually execute some code in order to do the processing of my packet, that worries me. Already we talk a lot about privacy and the fact that in corporate networks and university networks, we are losing a lot of privacy. People are watching what's going on. And now saying that the routers are going to do something intelligent or smart, processing packets, that might be a socially and psychologically unacceptable proposition. So these are reasons why it may make it difficult to sell the idea of active networks to the wide area internet. On the other hand, the idea of virtualizing the network flow is very appealing. And if you put together the two thoughts that I had, one is the idea that you can virtualize the network, and the second, that active networks is only feasible at the edge of the network, that brings up a very interesting proposition, which I'm going to mention in my concluding remarks.